This is one rod. Length of this rod is L. And linear charge density of this rod is given lambda. So lambda is equal to Q divided by L, charge per unit length. At a distance r from this rod, at distance r at point P, I need to find out electric field. So I select one element at distance x from this, at distance x from this point, one element, and thickness of this element is dx. This thickness is dx. This distance I am taking d, this one let it be r. So if this angle is theta, so this angle will be very small, let's say this one is d theta. Now r square is equal to x square plus d square, and from this triangle, if you look at this triangle, x divided by d is equal to tan theta. So x divided by d is equal to tan theta, it means x is equal to d tan theta. If I differentiate this one, I'll get dx is equal to d sec square theta d theta. So if I want to find out r square in terms of d, so in place of this x, I'll write d tan theta. So r square is equal to d square tan square theta plus d square. So r square is equal to d square 1 plus tan square theta, that will be equal to sec square theta. So r square is equal to d square sec square theta. Now I want to find out electric field at this point due to this small element. So direction of electric field will be like this. If I take another element over here, so direction of electric field due to this element, it will be in this direction. So if I divide this electric field into two components, one along this axis, another perpendicular to this, like this one. And here also one electric field along this axis and one perpendicular to this. So perpendicular component, if we see, it get cancelled. It means if I select two element, I'll get 2dE cos theta. dE cos theta due to this element and dE cos theta due to this element. Now for complete rod, total electric field will be integration of dE cos theta. So E dash is equal to integration of dE cos theta. Now what is dE? dE is electric field due to this small element. So charge on this small element, that will be lambda into dx, because lambda is linear charge density. So dq is charge on this element, that will be lambda into dx. Lambda is charge per unit length, and length of this one is dx. So how much charge will be there? Lambda into dx is equal to dq. Now dE I can write k into dq divided by r square. Now dq, what I can write? Lambda into dx. So dE is equal to k lambda dx divided by r square. Now in this equation, E dash is equal to dE cos theta. In place of this d, I'll write this value and cos theta as it is. So E dash I'll get, E dash is equal to k lambda dx divided by r square cos theta. Now in place of dx, I'll write this value, and in place of r square, I'll write this value. So if I substitute this value of dx and r square from these two, from equation A and equation B, what I'll get? I'll take k lambda outside because it's a constant. So k lambda in place of dx, I am writing d sec square theta d theta and cos theta as it is. In place of r square, I am writing this value. So d square sec square theta. So d 1d get cancelled from this one, sec square theta, sec square theta get cancelled. So I'll get e dash is equal to k lambda d integration of cos theta d theta. Now what will be limit of integration if I select this element over here? So angle is theta. If I select this element at this point, theta will be 0. If I select this element over here, it means theta will be minus theta. If I select element over here, something else will be there. So if I select element at this end, this one, let's say this angle is theta 1. And if I select element over here, top point of that, let's say that angle will be, that total angle will be theta 2. So it means I need to integrate this expression from minus theta 1 to plus theta 2. So I integrate from minus theta 1 to plus theta 2. Integration of cos theta, that will be my sine theta, and limit of this one, theta 1 minus theta 1 to theta 2. So if I put limit, so e dash is equal to k lambda by d sine theta 1 plus sine theta 2, and direction will be away from this rod. It means along I cap.